in your view, the most critical element for futures thinking and for creative thinking?
First of all, thank you very much. I think creative thinking should be linked with futures thinking, because the use of tools for both futures and creativity involves and develops flexible mindsets. And the way change has become so exponential today, we are living with change all around us, we cannot be stuck in ways of thinking, in ways of acting, not even in ways of solving problems or in ways of looking to the future. We have to be very, very flexible, and we also need to use our imagination much more. And the imagination, of course, is linked a great deal to creativity, because in my opinion, if you want to be creative, or if you want to assess or evaluate something to see whether it is creative or not, the two main elements are generally originality and surprise. That when you see it, hear it, observe it, whatever, you get that aha, so things can be done that way too. There are other elements, of course, which one can bring in, but those are the two main ones, really. Originality and surprise. And in order to achieve that, you definitely need the imagination, and you also need the imagination to look to the future. And to use the imagination, you cannot be locked into the mindsets that unfortunately most people get stuck in from quite early years of education, when you learn how to give a teacher the answer you know the teacher wants.
Yes.
And unfortunately, some people remain on that track for long periods of their life, if not forever.
That's right.
We need to get them out of that way of thinking, to be much more flexible.
And more open and out of the box thinking.
More open, adaptive, recognizing opportunities.
Yes.
And stretching their brains.
That's right. But how do you think companies, organizations could do in order to build that kind of atmosphere that creativity and futures thinking is possible?
Yes, there are quite a few tools, methods one can use for thinking out of the box, for generating ideas. And they include, for example, the six thinking hats, which Edward de Bono had invented. And they are very, very easy to learn. They can be used by anyone from all ages. And they can also be applied to foresight, as can also another method which I have used for simple scenario building exercises, which is called random input, where you bring something into the situation to help you to generate ideas and then apply it to the scenario. For example, universities in 2030, or tourism in Finland in 2030, or whatever topic, media journalism in 2030, or whatever. And it helps a lot when you use these methods, combining creativity tools with foresight tools, because it also acts to some extent as an icebreaker. And when you have a group of people together, whether they are experts or general public or whoever, you do need to get them into a more relaxed frame of thinking, from my experience at least. And by using these methods, one does get them to relax their brains and to stretch their imagination a lot more than they would. Plus, it also gradually helps them to build up trust, because you do not exchange your ideas unless you trust the other people within the group in which you are operating.
That's a very important aspect you have to have.
I think so.
And finally, I would like to ask you, what do you consider to be the most important competence or skills in the future, in future working life?
Yes, that's not an easy question to answer. But I think it is a sense of developing a sense of curiosity, learning to learn, which helps one to adapt to situations, and it can be linked then to this willingness to go for lifelong learning, because we cannot stop learning when we finish school or university or what. So I think we need to build up a skill.
Yes.
Besides to have flexible attitudes and mindsets, also to develop that curiosity to want to learn more, understand more, and never to stop the learning process.
That's right, and a continuous process. So thank you very much, Sandra.
Thank you very much. Thank you.